He's a musician, singer and songwriter, and this evening ELO's Jeff Lynne will be honoured with a place on Birmingham's Walk of Stars. He'll join fellow musicians Ozzy Osbourne, Tony Iommi and Roy Wood in having a star etched with his name on Broad Street. Ben Sidwell has been to meet the rock legend.
Back in Brum for the unveiling of his star. A lot's changed since Jeff Lynne grew up as a kid in the Shard End area of Birmingham.
My memory is I used to have my own little studio in the front room of my mum's house, which I'd commandeered as a recording studio, which was like a big bundle of junk and rubbish. And she used to drive her nuts, you know, like she used to, oh, don't let anybody in that room. Of course, I'd let everybody in there because to have a listen to my new stuff. We used to play a different place every night for a month and then start again, round and round and round and round.
After failing to set the charts alight in the 1960s with his band The Idle Race, Jeff went on to join The Move, which in turn became ELO, selling tens of millions of records and winning fans across the world.
Hi, I'm Daisy and I'm from Cardiff.
I'm Marcos.
I'm Mauri.
I'm Jose.
And we're from Spain.
I am Hans.
I'm Niels and we are from Denmark.
A few lucky fans have got tickets for tonight's Walk of Fame event and the chance to meet their idol.
Oh, yeah. Oh, it'd be wonderful. Just wonderful. I don't know what I'd say to him, but I'd just cry, I think. Just want a hug.
I've dreamt of this all my life, and I'm really looking forward to only see him. I don't have to talk with him. If I could talk with him, that would be excellent, but I liked his music for all my life.
What will it mean if you do get a chance to meet him, get a chance even to talk to him?
It will be the greatest thing in my life.
It makes you really humble, I can tell you that much. It's like, why did you come all this way? I'd have come to see you, if you'd have said. It's just weird, you know, it's just so strange. When it's yourself and they're coming for it, you just don't believe it. You know, it's kind of, wow, that's amazing.
But it's not just as an artist where he's been a huge success. Jeff's produced such names as Roy Orbison and Tom Petty. And in the 1990s, when the three remaining members of the biggest group in history reformed, it was Jeff they called.
I had a couple of sleepless nights thinking, how the hell am I going to do this? And finally I got the hang of it and did it, and it worked. So I was really pleased because Paul came up to me, we have done it, well done. Gave me a big hug. So that was a treat.
Songwriter, singer, drummer, guitarist. You know, you can do it all. He's not bad at all. Feeling the way on the crest of a
wave, it's like magic. He may be a global music star, but to one of the people there tonight, Jeff will always be her baby brother.
We came from a family where praise wasn't exactly lavished upon us, so I don't maybe think we've ever been able to express how proud we are of Jeff.
And as for his award,
I kind of wondered when I was going to get one, if I was going to get one, because I know it's been going for a while, and so I'm chuffed I've got one. Yeah, thank you very much. The peak of it probably is doing the Beatles record, because it was almost impossible to do, because all they got was a cassette with John singing at the piano, and it's like ding a ding a ding, and the voice stuck to it in mono. So I had to somehow get John's voice above. I made this great big Beatles track, like this backing track that was a big giant thing, and then I had to put the vocal in, which was this cassette, and the piano, so and try and get rid of the piano. So a wonderful thing, Paul ghosted John's voice a little bit underneath, which gave it a little bit more edge so it would cut through on the record, you know. But it was very, very difficult, and I had a couple of sleepless nights thinking, how the hell am I going to do this? And finally I got the hang of it and did it, and it worked. So I was really pleased, because Paul came up to me, we have done it, well done. Gave me a big hug. So that was a treat.
So many of the tracks are still being played, you know, 40 years on now.
I find it absolutely fantastic, you know, and I can't imagine how it happened, because I was just, when I wrote them, I'd be just getting in the studio and just doing them. And if they got in the charts then, like that 40 years ago or 35 years ago, it was like a treat anyway. Oh, I've got a hit, thank you.
And fans literally from across the world think,
as far away as South America are coming here tonight to A, try and get the chance to meet you, because that's their dream, and to see you in your home city?
Well, it makes you really humble, I can tell you that much. It's like, why did you come all this way? I'd have come to see you, if you'd have said. It's just weird, you know, it's just so strange. When it's yourself and they're coming for, you just don't believe it, you know. It's kind of, wow, that's amazing. But you can't, it never really sinks in. You know, my star doesn't really sink in on the Walk of Fame. It's like, it's marvellous, and yet I can't really believe it's happened yet, you know, until I actually see it. So, and the obviously the doctorate from the Birmingham City University was a fabulous treat as well. It was, you know, I didn't believe that would ever happen, and that's, it just goes to show, everything comes to him what waits.
And that was Ben Sidwell reporting. Jasper Carrot is chair of the Birmingham Walk of Stars. Delighted to say he joins us now from the Library of Birmingham, where the ceremony is taking place. Good evening, Jasper.
Hi, now, Mary, how are you?
I'm all good with me, thanks. You've known Jeff for, I won't embarrass you, but a number of years, shall we say. Why has it taken so long to get his star on the walk?
Well, I first approached Jeff about 4 years ago, and it's taken all this time to sort of coincide his movements with ours. But eventually he's here, he's waiting to come on, there's a load of people waiting to see him. And the place is buzzing, the publicity has been enormous. And Jeff is genuinely thrilled to be here. And we're going to be thrilled to see him.
And we heard in Ben's report there the international appeal of Jeff. How would you sum up, if it's possible, to sum up his contribution to music?
Well, I think when the Beatles approached him to do that single, it said it all, because they could have gone to anyone in the world, but they chose Jeff Lynne. And Jeff Lynne's music is all over the world, not just on CD and DVD, but on film scores, you name it. And that's an incredible achievement.
Paul McCartney described him as not bad at all. How would you sum him up?
He's a Brummie. He's a down-to-earth, honest Brummie, and he's come home, and we're thrilled to see him.
And that's what we love about him, part of what we love about him. So who next, Jasper, for the walk?
Oh, there's a whole list of people. People are contacting me all the time. You know, there's Duran Duran, Ian Lavender from Dad's Army, Anne Jones, the Wimbledon champion. They're all born in Birmingham, and they all deserve a place, but of course there's only so much room. I think we're going to have to move to the M6 eventually.
I was going to say, you're going to run out of Broad Street. Jasper, have a great evening. Lovely to speak to you.
Thanks, Mary.
Thanks. Bye-bye.